nobody was making an issue of us being two women. So it was wonderful and better than we had hoped for. And now maybe we can have another picture of Jóhanna playing with her grandchildren. This is Christmas, and there are more grandchildren now. There are 8 altogether. And this is a rare occasion. Most of the kids only knew her, you know, only met her, you know, at very special occasions, and they saw her on television more than they did at home. And maybe the next photo is from, this is an official visit that we went to the Faroe Islands. The Faroe Islands are governed by Denmark, and they are a very typical Nordic country, but we, the only time we met with any, you know, difficulties is in, on this visit, because there was this member of parliament who didn't want to come and have dinner. You always have official dinners in these visits, and he didn't want to sit down and have dinner with us because we were a gay couple. And the people of the Faroe Islands, they were really sorry about this. This is the Prime Minister and his wife. They didn't have an LGBT association back then, and it was a very oppressed people left to Denmark who were gay in the Faroe Islands. But only a few weeks after, this caused a lot of attention, our visit, and the rudeness of the MP who didn't want to have dinner with us. Only a few weeks later, they established an LGBT association. Now they have annual gay parades, and they are even have civil partnership as of just a few weeks ago. So everyone has changed. Maybe another photo? Yeah, this, you may know Santi Toksvik, who's on the left. If you know QI, the TV program with Stephen Fry, she is taking over as host later this year. And we got to know her through my writing, not Jóhanna, amazing. Okay, another one. Now I will be quick. This is from another official visit. We went to Beijing, the Prime Minister of Iceland visiting the Prime Minister of China, which was an you know, unbelievable experience. We didn't know how things would be, because obviously they have completely different views of gay rights, but they were extremely polite. Everything was really courteous, and we had a lovely visit there. And we have some more photos from that, I think. Yeah, there's Jóhanna on the red carpet with the Prime Minister of China, and the, you know, the honors of, and everything, the a proper official visit. We got a lot of reaction from people in China, LGBT people who sent messages saying how important this was for them, because having been maybe thrown out of their families, whatever, they can take the newspaper and show their family, see our Prime Minister is being polite and accepting a visit from another Prime Minister who has a same-sex partner. Okay, I think we'll be quick now. This is also in China, it's taken from afar, so this is on the red carpet, the Prime Minister of China, Jóhanna, and myself, just about to walk into the official banquet. And another one. That's the official banquet. You can see Johanna's white hair everywhere. So it's obvious where she is, and the Prime Minister is behind her, by her side, and then I'm on the other side. So everything was done properly, like, you know, they showed us full respect. Another one, that's, I had a spouse program, of course, very proper, going to a university. Okay, another one, we're just coming to the end. This is Jóhanna protesting outside the Russian embassy. Now, obviously, she has retired, and this was not while she was Prime Minister, and now we are doing other things, and she was protesting the anti-gay laws.